At 14 minutes to four, amid uproar in the Commons, and after 4 months of public agonising, Michael Heseltine finally sounded the death knell for Margaret Thatcher's flagship tax.
After a careful reappraisal of the options, we have decided in principle to bring forward a new local tax, under which there will be a single bill for each household comprising two essential elements.
He then went on to outline those elements. The new tax is based on property values and the number of adults living under each roof. It maintains the central plank of the poll tax that all adults should contribute towards local services. The unprecedented political U-turn brought swift condemnation.
We have just heard the most complete capitulation, the most startling U-turn, and the most shameless abandonment of consistency and principle in modern political history.
Why has the Secretary of State chosen to move from the most unpopular local tax ever to the second most unpopular local tax ever, straight from the frying pan into the fire?
The government's promised financial help to ease the transition to the new tax and has warned high-spending councils they'll be penalised if they exceed cash limits.
It's chaos in the short term because we're left with the nightmare of the poll tax, which has lost credibility and which is becoming increasingly hard to collect. And it's chaos in the longer term because you're going to have a two-pronged tax.
I'm obviously delighted that the government has once more asserted its belief that local services should be delivered by local government. Also pleased that they've rejected the wholesale funding of local government nationally, the rejection obviously of local income tax, the local sales tax, and obviously the rejection of rates.
Today's announcement spells the end of a tax which has seen some of the highest and lowest local charges in London and the South East. The capital greeted the poll tax with a reception which was sometimes good, sometimes bad, and sometimes ugly. Westminster unveiled a tax of £195, but it was the Tory Showcase Authority of Wandsworth which could claim the lowest charge in the country.
What this shows is that in London it is possible for a council to run outstanding services at a low cost.
But Labour accused the government of subsidising its favourite London boroughs with big cash handouts. The capital's Labour authorities began setting some of the highest charges in the country, £573 in Haringey and £548 in Lambeth. They faced, on the one hand, anti-poll tax demonstrators, on the other, charge-capping decisions in the courts, which forced them to cut poll tax demands and services. But London's ugliest and most violent reaction came on a spring afternoon in the centre of the capital itself. Last March's poll tax riot left more than 400 injured in some of the worst scenes of violence this century. Tonight, anti-poll tax protesters were jubilant at the announcement.
We know that it's going to take 2 to 3 years, but we see this as a big victory for non-payment, and obviously we'll continue our campaign to defend people until the poll tax is well and truly buried.
The new local tax is due to come into operation between 1993 and 1994. This is Jane Ball for Thames News.